Welcome to the October Viva Vegan Podcast, the voice of Europe's largest vegan campaigning charity. In this month's episode, we give you another selection of vegan exclusives from the top floor of the Viva headquarters in Bristol. So, just some of what's coming up. We have an interview with Carlo Sullivan, who is a YouTube vegan rapper who filmed himself in a van doing an amazing rap focused around answering many of the questions that vegans get asked. Alongside that, we speak to Viva vegan campaigner Laura, who's going to tell us about the latest campaign, and we've got lots more goodies for you. Now, you can hear this podcast via Apple Podcasts, Google Play in the USA, and lots of other apps and websites. Spread the word. Don't forget to share us on Facebook and Twitter. Let's get this free podcast out there, and you can get the podcast automatically on the first day of every month by subscribing. You're listening to Kris Townsend. I really hope you enjoy the show.
This is Kyle, aka the vegan rapper. I just want to say a massive thanks to the gang at Viva there. Words can't describe how much love and compassion I've got for these guys, man. They put their happiness to a side to give happiness to these other beings. And do you know what? That's the most selfless act you can do. So all I can do is just thank you on behalf of everybody and the animals, the vegans, everything, man. Because if everyone was like you, this world would be a better place.
So before we get going, let's have some news. Now, our biggest ever campaign was launched last week. We want to bring the first ever vegan cinema advert to the UK, and we need your help. Help us show 2 million people the contrast between a rescued pig's life in the rolling hills of the Welsh countryside and the lives of pigs on factory farms. Now, this stark contrast is going to help show ordinary people how important the change is, with a simple message at the end, just try being vegan. We have an advert, we've got the rating, all we need to do now is raise the media fees to get our groundbreaking advert out to a guaranteed audience of over 2 million cinema goers. Now, these people aren't going to know what hit them. We even have a generous donor who has promised to match every single donation up to the value of £50,000. So whatever you give is going to be doubled. Be a part of something huge, yeah? Let's make this happen between us. Help us show 2 million people that they can bring hope to millions too. Just go to viva.org.uk/bringhopetomillions. That's viva.org.uk/bringhopetomillions. Now, recently, thousands of vegans descended on central London as part of a global campaign for animal rights. Activists marched on the Houses of Parliament towards Hyde Park in a bid to fight animal oppression. Demonstrators worked to convince Londoners and people around the world, thank you to social media, that the life of an animal is worth far more than our taste buds. Images showed hordes of protesters carrying banners, displaying messages such as no excuse for animal abuse and pigs just want to have fun. And there were similar marches due to take place in New York, Los Angeles, Romania, in what many campaigners described as a consolidated global effort to make the vegan voice heard. Now, when it was organised last year, there were around 2,500 people. This year, there were 5,000. So really pleased that it doubled and the footage was absolutely incredible. This demonstration was actually organised by Earthling Ed Surge. And he said that to see so many vegans take to the streets is a humbling sign of the changing attitude society is having towards the treatment of non-human animals. And I've got to agree. As vegans, we stand against all forms of oppression, with no exceptions defined by species, and it's time for society to understand that the life of an animal is worth far more than our taste buds. So this is a second annual official animal rights march, and last year, as I said, over 2,500 people marched through the streets of the capital city to campaign for animal rights. This year it doubled. Here's the speech that Earthling Ed and Joey Carbstrong gave during that talk. Well done, fellas. Absolutely blinding and very inspirational.
It is time for us to stand up, speak up, and say no longer will we tolerate these industries that exploit and murder animals. No longer will we remain silent whilst those we care about are suffering. No longer will we allow these industries to continue. No longer will we allow these acts of evil to be carried out. It is time for us to rise up and shout, not in my name! These industries may have fooled us, deceived us into thinking it was okay to support the slaughter of animals, but no longer will we stand for it. And the fight ahead will not be easy. We'll face challenges because the corporations and industries that we're up against will not go down without a fight. But they will not win. They they will never win. Yes, because for all of their money and for all of their political influence, we have one thing they will never have. We have the truth. It is time for us to stand up and put ourselves in the position of these animals. What if it was you in the truck on the way to the slaughterhouse? What if it was you tied down to the operating table in the laboratory? What if it was you in that cage in the fur farm, or you in that circus ring being goaded to perform tricks? What would you expect of those who claim to care about you? Would you expect them to be silent, or would you expect them to rise up, stand up, and protect you? To understand why we must all be active, we need only put ourselves in their position, feel their pain, feel their suffering, feel their anguish for 1 second. This is why we must all be active. Because if it was us in their position, we would expect others to fight on our behalf. Yeah. I promise you a future exists where the last wall of every slaughterhouse is knocked to the ground. I promise you a future exists where every cage and every laboratory is empty forever. I promise you a future exists where every animal in the wild is allowed to roam freely without fear of being hunted by humans. I promise you a future exists where every animal is treated with love, respect, kindness, dignity and compassion. I promise you a future exists where the last animal farm is closed and burnt to the ground. A reality, if we want to see a vegan world, then it's time that we all face the burden that lies on each and every one of our shoulders. Don't expect others to fight the battles that we all must collectively share. Don't expect others to create this world on their own. The future is there in front of us, but we must seize it together. There is no more time for excuses, no more time for complacency or apathy. Now is the time to come together, to fight together, and to win together. Each and every one of you came here today because you felt that fire inside of you, that obligation to make your voice heard and to oppose the industries that think they can exploit and kill animals without consequence. Every single one of you came here today because you felt that responsibility, that desire to create a brighter future for all life. Every single one of you came here today so that when the future generations ask you, what did you do? You can say that you stood on the right side of history. Most of us weren't born vegan. Many of us paid for animals to suffer and die. Animals suffered and died for us, so that we could eat their flesh and wear their skin. And as such, we have a moral obligation to fight to protect their brothers and sisters. But we fight not only to protect the animals that are yet to be bred, we fight to beg for forgiveness from the ones that died for us before. The way I see it, animals had their lives taken from them by us. So the least we can do is fight with the rest of our lives for them. Yeah! Our existence on this planet is only temporary, but the world that we leave behind will define the future and outlive us forever. Now is the time. Now is the time. The time to fight. We fight together. We fight for the animals. We fight for the planet. And we never stop fighting. We never back down. We never back down and save the animals. Thank you.
When it comes to being an activist, we have to be brave. Courage isn't something you're born with. It's something you build on and work on. It's something that comes from gradually stepping outside of your comfort zone and speaking out against injustice. Courage is feeling the fear and doing it anyway. Yeah. Today we march together for animal liberation. We march together for the plight of animals. Today we march for those who can't march for themselves. Yeah. We shout loud our truth for those who can't speak for themselves. And we'll stand up and fight for those who can't defend themselves. Yeah. Never never underestimate the power of a fearless, dedicated group of activists.
Yes.
This is the power we have when activists unite. And we won't stop until we have total animal liberation. Yeah. Never give up. Thank you.
And that was the Earthling Ed and Jerry Carbstrong speeches from the animal activist group Surge Animal Rights March in London recently.
Viva Shop. We lovingly handpick our merchandise, scouring the planet for animal-free amazingness and handcrafted herbivore delights. For the best in vegan-friendly beauty, books, clothing, accessories, food and gifts, shop kind at the Viva Shop. Go to vivashop.org.uk. That's vivashop.org.uk.
Regarding Hogwood, I'd like to give you a Hogwood update. Now, the campaign is still continuing. We're still collecting signatures, so please share our petition. We will be contacting Tesco again soon to present them with the petition and ask them again to stop using Hogwood as a supplier. In the meantime, you can still order materials to door drop or hold a demo. Plus, you can show the footage to the manager of your local store and ask them to ask Tesco to stop using Hogwood as a supplier. Now, this October, we're going to be driving around an 11-metre screen showing footage contrasting the lives of rescued and farmed pigs. There's going to be 7 cities and it's going to be hard to miss. We're going to be showing footage in 8 universities, as well as targeting busy spots in city centres, the supermarkets, shopping centres, that sort of thing. And we're going to be showcasing our 3D face-off footage with our VR headsets and doing positive vegan outreach too. So giving the public information about farming and samples of vegan food, etc. Vegan sausage as well. So if you want to see the van in action, join us on social media for updates. You can go to our Facebook, Twitter or Instagram. Or, you never know, you might even see it driving around a city near you. Now, many of you are aware of James Aspie. He's a cracking advocate for veganism, very articulate, puts it really well and charismatic. Here, James discusses why we shouldn't be using dairy and the process behind the dairy industry. And he sums it up so well, it's hard to argue.
Now, a lot of people don't know this about dairy. I'm going to tell you what happens in the dairy industry. Obviously, meat, it's been cut off an animal's body, suffering and death, no doubt. But in the dairy industry, we see this carton of milk, this white liquid, with this silhouette picture of this happy cow, and you don't think anything of it. But in fact, the dairy industry is at least as cruel as the meat industry. So this is what happens. First of all, for a cow to give milk, just like a human, she has to either be pregnant or have recently given birth. For that to happen in the dairy industry, a human will shove their arm into her anus and then inject her vagina with bull semen. They do this on an apparatus in the industry commonly known as a rape rack. She has a 9-month pregnancy, just like a human, and then gives birth. When she gives birth, her babies are taken from her because they can't have the babies staying around drinking all the milk that the humans want. So they separate the mothers from the babies. And this is one of the most traumatic experiences for a mother cow in her life, and they do not have a good life. She'll often cry and bellow for days, returning to the same spot she last saw her babies, looking in the same direction she last saw her babies. It's traumatic. The babies, they're also obviously fried and scared, pining for their mother. And the baby boys, the waste products, are sent to the slaughterhouse. At the slaughterhouse, the babies will be shot in the head with a bolt gun. It fires a bolt through their skull into their brain, just to pierce their brain enough to stun them. And then they get their throats slit. These babies, the most cute, innocent beings on this planet, so gentle, so soft, couldn't hurt you if they tried. That's how we treat them. And we call this something humane slaughter. We call it humane. So I'll tell you the definition of humane. Humane means to show compassion. Is there a compassionate way to murder somebody? Is there a compassionate way to abuse a child? Is there a compassionate way to slit a baby animal's throat? There is no compassionate way to kill somebody who doesn't want to die. The industry, obviously so clever, so much money behind them to market these products of cruelty. It's a very clever word they use to make us feel better about our choices. The best way to figure out if something's humane or not is to ask yourself how you would feel in their situation. Would you agree that it's humane? Would you like it to happen to you or one of your family members? I definitely don't want to be humanely slaughtered. I definitely don't want that to happen to one of my family members. You imagine it like this. I've got a brother. His name is Jono. Love him. He's a legend guy. And I let him free range every day. And then one day in his sleep, boom, I shoot him. He didn't feel it. He didn't see it coming. Now, that's not what happens to these animals, but let's say it was. And I go to the court and I say, relax, judge, humane murder. Is he going to be like, oh, of course. Did you eat him after? Yeah, no worries. Don't worry about it. No. He's going to say, there is no humane murder. What are you talking about? You have robbed him of his greatest gift. You've robbed him of his life, the most precious thing any of us will ever possess. You've robbed him of his entire future, his entire existence. That's one of the most cruel things you can do. Doesn't matter if they see it coming or not. Doesn't matter if they felt it or not. It is still so cruel. And that's what happens to these baby boys. The baby girls have the same fate as their mother, forcibly impregnated, babies taken from her, hooked up to painful milking machines that will cause all different kinds of infections like mastitis. And then after 5 to 7 years of being so severely exploited, they can't continue anymore. And they also are sent to the slaughterhouse, humanely slaughtered. And in nature, cows can live 25, 30, sometimes even a bit older, 30 years old. So these are like children, basically, we're doing this to. Why? Why do we do all this? Why all this cruelty? Why all this deception? Why all this killing of these gentle, innocent animals? People like a piece of cheese on their sandwich. People like having a bit of cow's milk in their coffee, a bit of cow's milk on their cereal. The beauty is that we have alternatives to cow's milk. We're not baby cows. We got soy milk, rice milk, almond milk, coconut milk, hazelnut milk. This is how easy it almost always is to be vegan. You go to the supermarket, the one you always shop at, and you're about to get the cow's milk, and then you go, oh, I'm vegan now. And then you just do this. And you just get different milk, soy, rice, almond. That's it. So easy, man. So easy. Even if you didn't have it, cheese is not oxygen. We can live without it. We don't need it. There's literally thousands and thousands of different foods we can eat without all that cruelty. So this is the dairy industry.
And that was James Aspie talking about dairy very well, I might add. Now, if you're a member, you'll be aware that you get your copy of our membership magazine, Viva Life, 3 times a year. If you're not a member, you might not be getting it, although you may have had a sample copy at one of our festivals. Come and check it out if you haven't seen it. Become a member. You can join online at viva.org.uk/join or call us at the office on 0117 944 1000. That's 0117 944 1000. Viva Life, our membership magazine for all the latest vegan news, views and interviews. I'm sure it's happened to everybody, in fairness. Meat eaters that don't really have the understanding or sensitivity about what we're doing to be able to deal with it, almost. Anyway, here are some of the worst things people say to a vegan.
Hello, this is Kris.
Hello,
Kris. Nice to meet you.
Darling.
Come in, come in. Now, Kris, we know you don't eat meat, eggs or dairy, so we know you're not usual.
What she means by that is I'm vegan.
Thank you, Mum. That was lovely.
You're welcome, sweetheart.
And what about you, Kris? How is your lettuce?
So, is it an attention thing?
Dad.
I hide from the window cleaner and I think a haircut feels like small talk at knife point. I don't do anything for attention.
Would cows explode if we didn't milk them?
Mum, they're mammals like us. They only produce milk when they have a baby and
So they're kept in a constant cycle of pregnancy and nursing to give us all the milk we take?
If we weren't meant to eat meat, why have we got these teeth? We must have these teeth for a reason.
Opening bags of Skittles?
Can you have Skittles?
Doubt it. They've probably got mayonnaise in them. Oh, can I have a bag of unicorn's tears instead?
Oh, can we please change the subject?
Oh, good idea, darling. So, Kris, if you were on a desert island...
Yes. What would you eat on a desert island?
I've been asked to picture myself on a desert island so often that I feel like I've got my own private beach. I'd probably just get a falafel from the falafel stand.
What?
There's a falafel stand on the island.
No, there isn't.
Yeah, there is. When I washed up, he was about to close down, and then I came along, and I was like, I don't really know what I'm going to eat, because I'm a vegan. He said, oh, well, you are. Look, I think my point is, I'm not going to be on a desert island, am I?
Ooh, too much.
Excuse me.
Hitler was a vegetarian.
He also had a dog, but you don't hear people go, you got any pets? Yeah, I've got a dog. Oh, well, you know, Hitler had a dog. I think we might have got off on the wrong foot with the whole vegan thing. Just so you know, not eating meat is the only thing I've got in common with Hitler.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, probably shouldn't have been so hard on you. You've made your choice and I respect that.
Would you like some wine?
Oh, no, thank you.
What was that? Got mayonnaise in as well, has it?
No, fish bladders.
Oh.
You're listening to the Viva podcast for October 2017, and my name's Kris Townsend. I hope you're enjoying the show. I just wanted to let you know before we go to the next piece that we have another festival lined up in Brighton. God, that reminds me of partying in the past, but this is just a festival, fortunately, that's in the daytime. So it's on the 7th and the 8th. In Brighton, there's going to be talks, demos, workshops, and all the latest vegan information. Oh, and lots of yummy vegan samples as well for food. So you can eat your way around the festival. And if you can't be there, follow us on social media. That's Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. If you want more information about the Brighton Festival or any others that we hold, go to viva.org.uk/festivals.
Viva's undercover exposés are changing the face of Britain. Every year, millions of people see the true face of animal farming because of us, and they're changing their diet. Meat and dairy consumption is falling. By joining Viva, your donation will help to keep up this vital work. We need your support. Join Viva today so we can keep on saving animals from suffering. Join online at viva.org.uk/join. viva.org.uk/join.
Recently, TGI Fridays is rolling out the Beyond Meat Burger. Now, whatever your thoughts on Beyond Meat and the meat that's grown in a Petri dish or such like, it brings a lot of different thoughts to a lot of different people, depending on where you stand. But Gary Yourofsky has publicly said, look, He's up for it. He thinks as long as it saves animal lives, it's a good thing. Here's what he said.
I want the rape, enslavement, baby stealing, and murder of animals to stop immediately. I would do anything in my power to make their pain and suffering stop. This is why I'm standing behind the super meat, bio, fabrication, cultured meat movement, which creates meat in a petri dish, in a building, without pain and suffering. Without torture, without rape, without stealing babies, and without murder. I know it seems like an odd solution to this problem, but we have to understand that ethics is at the heart of the animal liberation movement, of the vegan movement. So if we can eliminate all the suffering and all the torture and the torment that animals go through, we have to stand behind that. Now, I don't believe that the super meat movement is for vegans. We already have our stuff. Fruits and vegetables, nuts and seeds, grains, legumes, and all the mock meats that exist right now from companies like Tofurky and Gardein. But this is a viable solution for the meat, dairy, and egg eaters of the world who just simply refuse to stop eating those animal products, those animal body parts. And if we can supply them with an ethical, viable solution, there's no reason why we shouldn't stand behind that. Support the super meat movement.
And that was Gary Yourofsky talking about Beyond Meat and why he thinks it's a positive thing. Next up is my interview with friend Carlo Sullivan, the cracking vegan rapper who came up with an amazing rap to answer all the questions that many vegans get asked. He videoed it in his van, and its DIY approach was certainly humbling, and boy, did it have a positive effect.
We're on, number one. So where do you get your protein from? Nuts, beans, tofu seeds, quinoa, lentils, hemp and peas, oat milk, spinach, and we know what's in it. I wish I could say the same for me. So is my boy, and so is broccoli. But you can only still need me. One, two. How do you afford to buy all that healthy food? The exact same way you've afforded to buy that iPhone, iPad, a brand new iMac, cars and clothes. You can't hide that. Your ego's bigger than your health. Try deny that and keep a straight face when you see yourself. Three, aren't we carnivores and supposed to eat meat? And that's why we have K-19 to tear through the flesh and bones and meat. No, wrong again, they're there to break through nuts and seeds. And that's why we share the same teeth as a cow and a horse and all the monkeys. And the same size intestines. So that when we're digesting, we take all the good from what we eat. They're not designed to digest meat. Our carnivores have a lot more short because it's supposed to pass that speed. That's why we are left with disease such as cancer and diabetes. Four, so you're sure you're 100% a carnivore. Okay, next time that you go to the store, just grab some chicken, bacon or pork. Open it up and eat it raw with no seasoning or no sauce. No more knives and no more forks. And let's see who's hitting the floor, cause all carnivores have paws and claws. We have hands to pick fruit and veg off trees and plants. So please understand, if you put fruit and a rabbit in a baby's cot, it will play with a rabbit then eat the fruit. Do the same with a lion's cub, and what do you think that lion will do? Five, if they're alive, they'll overpopulate the whole earth. But you still proceed to inseminate them, no, so that they give birth. That's 56 billion animals each year that are sent to slaughter. That's 56 billion animals that you can feed and water. That's 8 times the human race's population. Yet we can't stop hunger, poverty in every single nation. But that don't sit with me, and it really, really gets to me when you hear them stupid fluoride.
Yeah, but what about bacon, though?
Stupid. Number six, stones and sticks, fire pits made of bricks, cause we are cavemen. Well, if you're cavemen, where's your cave then? Seven, our Father who art in heaven, thou shalt not kill, but I will. Hail Mary, full of bring me a lamb with its throat slit, some mint sauce and a big portion of hypocrite, and we'll say grace, that's what we'll do, cause it's not dead if we call it food. Eight, I feel great, I've already had my fight for the day, I'm high for the day with a clear conscience, and it's not even quarter to eight, but the thing with meat is, well you see when they're killing them, they're just filling them with stress and adrenaline, and every bite that you're taking, you're taking your cheeseburger, but that's what you're taking in, and you wonder why that you look like shit, and you feel like shit, and you smile like where you are, where you eat, and where your eat's been dead for over 4 weeks. Eyes, ears, veins, teeth, balls, bums, tongues for me to eat a pig's arsehole. Here's 20 grand and a for mom. Nine, my bones are fine, there's no need to ask all the time, Mr. Orthopedic. But if you wanna go down them lines, then we can talk about bones and calcium. And now you think cow's milk is helping them, but the animal protein is so acidic that it leaches phosphate out of them. There is scary cowspiracy, go look it up. And while you're there, Google got puss and see the that's in one cup. Piss, purse, blood, hormone, stress, and all it's feared. Oh yeah, that tastes good. And you think breastfeeding's weird. 10. I forgot what I was gonna say, cause I didn't take my vitamin B12 supplement today. So I'll dance to the end with my best friend.
I'm here with a friend of mine called Kyle O'Sull. Now, Kyle caught my attention when I was flicking through YouTube and I found this guy doing the most awesome vegan rap. Now, it wasn't just me that thought so, because since then, this thing's gone viral. How you doing, Kyle?
I'm brilliant. All the better for talking to you, Chris.
Oh, mate, you're spoiling me. You're spoiling me. Listen, Kyle, there's a lot of people out there who may have seen the rap. What led you to that moment where you did that actual rap in that van?
People think I rap, that's what I do. I don't. Look, I've spoke to you about it before. When we were kids and that was the sort of music about, we all used to mess about doing it. I always used to always, with friends having banter, like make up funny little lyrics, just taking the mick and whatnot. And everyone used to love it. My good friend, Kath Kendall, she was like, you need to do a vegan rap. And I was like, yeah. She was like, no, I know it will be good. It's a good way to get the message out there. If obviously, because I had a little bit of humour in there with facts, people would listen. I had to think of how I was going to do it. And I thought, the only way that that would work, that vegans would like and people who aren't vegan would listen to, is the questions we get asked or the points that are always made. So obviously, like, oh, so where do you get your protein? And, oh, it's too expensive. And, yeah, but if we don't kill them, then they're going to overpopulate and take over the world. And the world will be ran by cows and goats and sheep. And, yeah, all of this. So I just thought I'd try and make it humorous. But at the same time, and the other thing I wanted to do as well is, because people think people are vegan just because they love animals and they don't think they deserve to be put through that, which is obviously the core reason. But there's other reasons which sort of open my eyes up to it. And that's obviously the effect it's having on the planet, the ecosystem. There's people in food poverty who we can't feed and give clean water to, yet we can feed animals that are 12 times the size and 8 times the amount of the Earth's population. So all these little things do make you think to veganism. And one of them reasons is good enough to go vegan. So yeah, I wanted to put it in a way where the questions we get asked and sort of answer them. And it was a good way to do it because no one can answer back.
Yeah, fair enough. And also, I mean, you know, you should probably get Kaf to be your agent from now on as well, because she's got some good ideas, I think, hasn't she?
she has, mate. To be honest with you, like I say, when our first she told me to watch, obviously, Gary Yourofsky's greatest speech and Cowspiracy and whatnot, because before I didn't even know what a vegan was. So the first thing I was doing was questioning why they were vegan, what it's about. And it sort of made sense, you know. And like I said before, I just thought vegetarians and, well, not even vegans, because I didn't know what one was, but I thought vegetarians were just these weird hippie people who they're just mad, like took way too many drugs as a kid and just, you know what I mean? And but then like when I was asking a question, she was just coming out with so much sense, and I felt silly.
Real talk.
I felt, yeah, exactly, mate. So like I say, it's been a really mad journey.
Tell you what though, I mean, you said something interesting just a minute ago, which was like, you know, you hadn't even heard of veganism before Kaf mentioned it to you. I think that, you know, obviously, you know, veganism in general, its profile is being raised to 560,000 now, isn't there? And it can make us feel like, oh my god, you know, it's working, we're doing it. But it's important not to rest on your laurels, because you didn't even know what a vegan was 6 months ago, you know.
No, you know what, mate, and that is another good point. We see a different world to everyone now. Our world is a vegan world, and it's crazy, because like I say, you put yourself in a position of someone who don't even know what a vegan is, or all of their posts on Instagram, there's no information, there's no news, there's no updates, there's no help or anything like that. So all they see is what people are up to, what they're wearing, blah blah blah. But like I say, when you're a vegan, that's your news. Vegans aren't against meat eaters. We're not against a player. We're against the game in a nutshell.
So there's many different types of delivery of the vegan message. And obviously there's so many different types of people out there. Each person's got their own delivery that's never wrong. It's always right for somebody, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly.
Your one comes across with a good sense of humour in your raps, and I can appreciate you might have got a few people's backs up and stuff as well. What's been the feedback from people?
I have had the most awesome feedback. I do come across confident, but if you look at the situation I'm in, I'm sitting in a van on my own, away from everyone. I could never do that with people in my sight. I'm such an anxious dude. I'm an overthinker. I've probably had about 150 plus messages since the first vegan rap, from a mixed bunch of people who have said they have gone vegan because of that.
Well, I'll tell you what, I mean, also, I mean, what you've probably done here as well is you've created just another bit of ammunition for us, you know, to be able to show people. Do you know what I mean? 100%. It's just another thing that people can use to show their mates and to show their parents and whoever it may be.
The only negative, obviously, I've had the odd, like, idiot who's just like, yeah, but I love steak, and steak's more important than that. Like, that's, I do get a bit of hate on Facebook and whatnot. Nothing my way, which, like I say, if no one says anything to me personally or knows me personally, I'll never take that personally. But the people who do give me stick are the intersectional vegans. First of all, it's like, okay, you probably don't like the way I am. That's fine. Like, it's not about the way I am. I'm spreading the same message as you. The fact is, it's like, we're on the same team, yeah? It's like, can we put our egos aside? Like, you might call me an ableist, a sexist, a bit. So what? Like, I know what I am, and that's what counts to me, because I can never lie to myself because I'll always know the truth. We're on the same side here, man.
Do you think there's a new wave of vegan blokes on the scene that go against the previous stereotypes of the sort of vegan man, so to speak?
Do you know what? I've so much love for these people, man. And like you said, there's no stereotype of a vegan anymore because I've seen so many different kinds of people go vegan from different backgrounds and people growing up in rough areas who are always around like thuggish behaviour, criminal activity and whatnot. It's like, that isn't who they are. That's what they grew up around. But he's turned vegan because he knows compassion. Musicians, they're bad examples, I know, but I'm just...
Well, mate, well, you've even got half a Wu-Tang clan going vegan nowadays.
There
you know what
you
I mean?
Go.
Public Enemy, Wu-Tang,
go,
JME, RZA.
Exactly, man. This is what I'm saying to you, mate. And I think, you know what, going back to the hate thing, I think, I don't like saying it because it makes me sound arrogant, but I think some people don't like me because they've seen someone who's gone vegan for 2 years and they've only just started like raising their voice over the past 8 months to a year. And because of I didn't ask for the impact of that rap. I got made to do it. and it sort of blew up, which I am so grateful for, man. Like, I don't regret that. Like, I didn't know it was going to happen. I'm not saying I didn't want it to. I didn't expect it. Like, I didn't expect that. So I had no intention of it. It wasn't to gain followers, this, that and the other. It was like, I think they don't like the fact of how big it got and how much attention come my way from. Hang on a minute. It's like, hang on a minute. I've been fighting for 10 years straight and I've been going to these marches every week and these pig saves and this guy who works 9 to 5 just does a little rap in the van and everyone wants to follow him and da-da-da. He's bad for our movement. And I've said it once and I'll say it again. I don't represent vegans. I don't represent veganism. I represent animals. And that's it.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, there's certainly no place for ego in a movement like this that should be focused purely around the animals. Have you got any more plans for any more raps?
100%. Like I say, I want to just do vegan, 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 vegan. Because like I say, I get overwhelmed by the messages and it's not feeding my ego. It's kind of giving me a kick up the arse to say, this is working, man. And like, this is touching people. This, people are saying, thank you, thank you. I think making people laugh is important, but making people think is even more important. My next plan for the next one was I wanted to do something around the whole Hogwood farm issue. And I wanted to contact Viva, get a footage of Hogwood Farm and sort of show it from a perspective.
Yeah, sure. And we'll help you with that as well. It's a great idea. We'd really appreciate that. Carl, you're on Instagram, aren't you?
Yeah, yeah.
That's your baby, yeah. Give everyone your Instagram details.
Instagram's all I use. I don't use Facebook. Kyle _ Osul. Kyle _ Osul.
Well, listen, I look forward to seeing you soon. It was actually Hogwood where I met you first, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, man. Yeah, definitely. So I think Hogwood's a very fitting thing to do next. So let's talk privately about what we can do to help you with that.
Definitely.
And, thanks for coming on the show. And send my love to Kath and we'll speak to you soon, yeah?
100%, mate.
And that was my interview with vegan rapper Carlo Sullivan.
30 Day Vegan with Viva. Sign up to our 30 Day Vegan program and we'll email you with top tips every day for 30 days. Our tips include tasty, healthy meal plans, celebrity vegan inspiration, nutritional advice, and health information. It's 100% free, so what are you waiting for? Go to viva.org.uk/30dayvegan. That's viva.org.uk/30dayvegan.
Now, you guys have been listening to me now for almost a year, so I'm sure you appreciate the dulcet tones, but you're probably wondering where on earth they come from. We are based in a little room in the Viva headquarters, and it's a room that I renovated to make into a makeshift studio booth. Pretty hot, but it really does the job. So we've had a few requests for photographs, so we're going to start putting those up on our website for you so you can check us out in action. And that will be at viva.org.uk/Viva Podcast. That's viva.org.uk/Viva Podcast. Now, this is a funny little version of 21 Pilots Heathens. It's a parody. It's pretty funny. Just relax. Enjoy it. I hope you like it.
All my friends are vegans, take it slow. Wait for them to force feed you tofu. Don't eat that, it probably contains shoes. Don't you know that comes from a cow's boobs? All my friends are vegans, take it slow. Wait for them to force feed you tofu. Don't eat that, it probably contains shoes. Don't you know that
to the room of people who have baby chickens that I loved one day, locked away. Just because you nugget lovers killed their brothers doesn't mean we judge your ways or your chicken fillets. You're loving on the chicken burger sitting next to you. I'm loving on the aubergine sitting next to you. You're thinking, how can I escape from sitting next to you? But after all I've said, please don't forget. All my friends are vegans, take it slow. Wait for them to force feed you tofu. Don't eat that, it probably contains you. Don't you know that comes from a cow's boobs? We don't deal with eating out very well. They say look up for there's a certain smell. Through pile plates will create tension. We just love to bathe in pretension. You're loving on the fat steak sitting next to you. You'll hate to have the vegan sitting next to you. They'll be going, did you know that meat is really bad for you? It is also responsible for a large proportion of global greenhouse gas emissions. Uses 70% of the Earth's fresh water. More than 50% of the world's land is completely unsustainable for a population of 7 billion people and growing. And causes 150 billion deaths per year for sweet, sweet baby animals. But after all, by the way, I'm vegan, did you know? I don't eat meat or dairy, just tofu. Don't eat that, it probably contains tubes. Don't you know that comes from a cow's boobs? Come when bacon's on your plate. I tried to warn you just to stay away. Now our facts have filled you with disgust. It looks like you might be one of us. All my friends are vegans, take it slow.
Next up, I'm speaking to Laura from Viva about a campaign she's organised to showcase our undercover footage in seven cities around the country on a huge screen on the back of a van. Let's check out what she's got to say. So I'm here with Laura from Viva's campaign team to talk about Viva's next big thing. Now, it's a big video van tour, which will be happening at the beginning of October and travelling around the UK. So, Laura, how are you doing? In fact, I don't think you've been on the podcast yet, have you?
No, it's my first time.
Oh, brilliant. Well, it's really good to have you here and introduce you to our listeners as well. So, Laura, tell us about the van tour.
So, yeah, the big Viva video van tour. Basically, we have an 11 square metre screen on a big van and we'll be touring through seven cities in the UK. Starting in Bristol, where we are based, going to Bath, Coventry, Birmingham, London, Brighton and Oxford. And on this big, big screen, we're going to show footage which basically contrasts the life of pigs and factory farms, in fact, of the undercover investigation Viva campaign still into Hogwood, with pigs who live in our beautiful sanctuary. So we want to show people, look how awful this one thing is, but look how you can save them and make them happy living in the sanctuary.
And this is going on the streets as well. So we're talking, this is going to be seen by not just vegans and vegetarians, but also a lot of meat eaters.
Exactly. That's the aim of the campaign. The whole thing. In the 7 days, we show this big footage, and then we have our 3D virtual reality headsets. Basically, we show nice footage, people come over, and then we show them, look, this is what it looks like in British factory farms. It will be in 3D, so it's really powerful. It actually feels like you're right there. And then we show, give them some meat alternative sausages and show them just how easy and positive it is to be vegan. And yeah, it's going to be a great piece of positive vegan outreach.
Fantastic. Yeah, exactly. Positive vegan. vegan outreach. You're going to be the feet on the ground. This is absolutely brilliant. I remember going up and down the country with the Face Off campaign last year and, you know, speaking to people from all walks of life, people who had never even considered veganism before. And it's tough. It's hard, isn't it? But it's necessary.
Yeah,
it's
definitely
really necessary.
And what we'll be doing as well is targeting unis, because we know university students are very like the right age range for people who are likely to go vegan. So we're going to show that at unis, the footage, and show them the Face Off 3D. So hopefully, yeah, we reach lots of people who just haven't just made the connection between the meat they're eating and how animals live in factory farms.
Yet. Good. So where will you go in the cities?
Yeah, as I said, so we're going to focus on like those seven big cities, and we're going to go to universities, very busy spots in the city centres. We're going to go to supermarkets, big shopping outlets. Yeah, to basically just meet a big crowd of like all kind of people, especially people who haven't made the connection, as I just said. And yeah, I'm looking forward to all the great conversations with people and eye-opening conversation for them, hopefully,
yeah,
as well.
Brilliant. Well, you're a very positive person. I feel very relaxed knowing that you're going to be out there talking to them with a smile on your face instead of giving it the angry vegan vibe, you know. So it needs some compassion, kindness, and understanding here. So what's the aim of the tour? I know it sounds a silly question, but can you explain it to the reader, listeners?
Yes, of course. So because we're going to show cute footage of, like, you'll probably remember the story of Hope and her piglets.
Yeah, yeah.
We're going to show them the beautiful footage we've taken at the sanctuary of them running around and show them, look how beautiful this is. And then hopefully draw some animal lovers in who actually say, oh, I really like this footage. I really want pigs to live that way. And then they can see in the 3D footage what it's like in a factory farm and then make the connection. And we reinforce that with like mock meat alternatives and just very positive outreach.
Brilliant. And how can people keep up to date with what's happening at the van tour?
I guess most of your listeners know our Facebook page, Viva! ! And yeah, we're going to post daily updates there. And hopefully if you live in one of those cities, please come along. We'll be touring around the city centres. And yeah, it would be great to see some of Viva supporters on the street.
Wonderful. Fantastic. Laura, thanks so much. We wish you the best of luck.
Thank you.
Now, I wonder whether the things that vegan couples say to each other are different to things that normal people say to each other or other couples say to each other. Do you know what? I think they're pretty much the same, but I bet you there's a few tweaks.
Hey, Doug.
Oh, you're sweating like a pig.
Pigs don't have sweat glands.
Movie night tonight, babe.
Forks over knives?
Yes.
What?
Is this condom vegan? So was your last partner vegan? Oh yeah, did you buy my niece something for her birthday? She's 10.
Yeah, the Earthlings DVD. I think it's time we adopt some fur babies.
Hey hon, where do you want to go for dinner tonight?
Look up, Happy Cow. Can we still call each other honey?
Done. I've just relocated all those ants that were on our mangoes into our garden.
Oh, babe, you're a level 20 vegan husband.
Thanks, babe.
Would you still be with me if I wasn't vegan? What are you thinking about?
How much water we're saving each year.
Why are you still hanging out with your deadbeat friend who you know eats bacon? I think we should get matching vegan tattoos. Hey, how did we sign the SeaWorld petition?
Where did we meet?
At the Blackfish screening. So they were dating for like 3 years and then he just decided to start eating meat again.
How did we go vegan? Gary Yourofsky speech.
We're having dinner with John and Harry on Friday night. Do you think we can veganise them?
Hell yeah.
Do I have lettuce in my tea?
I'm off to work, hon. Did you pack my falafel? Hey, hon, we're out of almond milk.
That smells great. What about adding some cinnamon to the curry?
Oh, baby, I love it when you talk dirty. Have you almost finished? You've been in the shower forever.
I'm vegan. I've got water credits.
You're listening to Kris Townsend presenting the Viva podcast every month for the latest vegan news, views and interviews. Now, I'm already thinking about next month's show and I suddenly realised it's going to be our anniversary, and our anniversary falls on World Vegan Day. Now, obviously, I want World Vegan Day to be every day, as I'm sure you do. But in the meantime, we're going to get as many goodies together for the next show. So make sure you keep listening to the Viva podcast.
At Viva, we rely heavily on the gifts that people leave to us in their wills. Without this generosity from our supporters, we would not be able to do the crucial work that we do, investigating industrial farming and slaughter, and saving animals. We also promote veganism to millions of people every year. Leave a legacy which will help make the world a better, kinder place after you are gone. Please consider giving to Viva in your will. To find out more, please visit viva.org.uk/legacies or contact Tony Wardle by email on tony@viva.org.uk or call 0117 944 1000.
Here is a short skit by Whitman Edison taking on Batman as the Dark Knight. Well, this version is the vegan Dark Knight. Enjoy.
Most people say they love animals, and that's fine. But then 56 billion farmed animals die every year, and nobody bats an eye. Because according to the corporation's plans, then I say two little words, go vegan, and everybody loses their minds! I'm just trying to introduce a little compassion into our society. I'm an agent for compassion. But it's normal to exploit and eat animals, even though we know we don't have to. And they call me the crazy one.
That was the October Viva Vegan Podcast. Thanks so much for listening. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember, we love to hear your thoughts, so please leave us a message on our website, viva.org.uk/Viva Podcast. Just click on the SpeakPipe button, leave your message, and it will automatically get sent to me. I'd love to share them on the show. Remember, the podcast goes out every month at the beginning of the month. It's free, it's a great online resource, and we need your help to get it out there far and wide. Until next time, be kind. This is Kris Townsend. Goodbye.